The Assembly will now hear a statement by His Excellency Omar Abdirashid Ali Sharmake, Prime Minister of the Federal Republic of Somalia. I request protocol to escort His Excellency. I have the great pleasure to welcome the Prime Minister of the Federal Republic of Somalia, His Excellency Omar Abdirashid Ali Sharmake. I invite him to address the Assembly.
Mr. President, Mr. Secretary General of the United Nations, honorable delegates, excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, let me first congratulate to Mr. Lakatov on your election as the president of the 70th session of the UN General Assembly. I'd also like to extend our appreciation to the outgoing president of the 69th session of the General Assembly, Mr. Sam Ketuza, for his stewardship this past year. It's an honor and a privilege to address this august gathering today. On behalf of the people and the government of the Federal Republic of Somalia, I extend a warm congratulations on the 70th anniversary of the foundation of the United Nations. For seven decades, the United Nations principles, goals of furthering peace, protecting security, and ensuring the advancement of human rights have indeed become unifying pillars of our global community. Somalia was one of the earliest African members of the United Nations and has been a member for more than 55 years. We have watched the United Nations grow, we have matured under its tutelage, and have now climbed back from a difficult phase in our recent history. Thankful for the support and backing from the members of this organization. 25 years ago, Somalia experienced its own Arab Spring prior to the current phenomena that has swept through much of the Arab world in the last few years. We have seen what can happen if the political demands of society are not adequately addressed, and we have learned from those lessons much too clearly through two challenging decades. That's why it pains us dearly to see fellow Arab and Muslim countries go through a very similar road. But it must be mentioned that through a perseverance and togetherness, Somalia is an example of what can be accomplished in such times. We are a nation that intimately understands those famous words by the American President John F. Kennedy that mankind must put an end to a war before the war puts an end to mankind. This year's theme of peace, security, and human rights is in line with the vision of my government. Indeed, a new Somalia is taking shape, and we intend to continue our climb from the dark. Mr. President, honorable delegates, ladies and gentlemen, I want to tell you about Somalia, but a different Somalia from the ones you might have heard of. I'm not here to challenge you on our neutrality as a result of a conflict that has spanned 2.5 decades. However, please allow me to introduce another reality. Somalia is home to a proud and industrious people. Despite adversity, we have become world-leading sportsmen, economists, artists, poets, musicians, entrepreneurs, and innovators. Even without the government, our business kept functioning. We remain a major player in the regional livestock trade and have one of the most innovative telecoms sectors in Africa. My people are ambitious and generous. During the famine, we gave more than all the aid agencies contributed. We have built banking systems based on social capital and trust, innovable networks that have attracted a range of investors. We are survivors, and given the chance, we can drive forward the socioeconomic landscape of East Africa. Imagine the potential. We have one of the longest shorelines in the world, which hosts untapped oil and gas reserves. We are actively rebuilding our country to realize this potential. We must be humble. Progress is slow, but look at where we have come from. The civil war destroyed our infrastructure institutions and took away some of our brightest minds. But now, they are coming back together. We are moving forward. We have defeated piracy, are embracing decentralization, and most importantly, we are learning lessons from our past. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, you have been together with us during this remarkable journey, and we thank you. My government has a vision to rebuild its institutions. Considerable progress has been made towards Vision 2016. 3 new interim regional states have already been formed. We are consulting our own people on how best to hold a free democratic elections, and we have established constitutionally mandated commissioners to ensure accountability. Allow me to elaborate on a few critical issues. First, we must ensure a free and fair elections. For this to be successful, we must agree with our constituencies on a fair and transparent voting system and how that can be cascaded to each region. Only through inclusion will draw public support. Let me remind you that Somalia was Africa's first country where a democratically elected president lost an election and gracefully transferred power. This history must define our future. We must also prioritize our national security forces. There is still an active insurgency which we are risking our lives to dismantle. For our own safety and for the security of our regions, last year, together with African Union forces, we liberated all major regions from Al-Shabaab. But our soldiers are underpaid, underfed, and under-equipped, and yet they are threatened to put their lives on the line for the country. This is unacceptable. We must invest in professionalizing our security and police forces. Peacekeeping missions work best when there are clear objectives and timelines to both restore stability and build the capacity of national security forces. I would like you to join me in paying tribute to all those who helped liberate us from violence, many of whom have paid the ultimate sacrifice. Our women, mothers, daughters, sisters also deserve limitless praise for enduring the worst of our brutal conflict. The survival instincts of the Somali people is most evident in women raising families whilst their homes are bombed, walking miles without water in search of safety, and burying their children whilst continuing to work to feed the rest of the family. We know what war can do, and that's why I will ensure as a father and as a husband that we will defeat terrorism. It's our duty as a government. Another issue of high importance is Somali refugees and undocumented migrants still living in temporary camps, some for more than 2.5 decades. We thank countries in the region for helping and hosting our people, but recognize that many continue to live in perpetual crisis without any hope of resettlement, residency, or citizenship. This is unacceptable. We urge our friends in this assembly to work with us in finding a durable solution. This transition will not be easy, but millions of lives depend on it. Ultimately, we must enable the rebuilding of state institutions and infrastructure. Effective and transparent institutions are prerequisite for providing services. Public services that many people around the world take for granted, Somalia lacks completely, or has in very short supply. For the past 2.5 decades, public services, including public schools, water, and power, have shifted and are run by private companies. It's critical that all Somalis feel they have a stake and a role in government. Residents of Somalia have the right to demand service from us. If we fail to provide such services, we risk falling short of our expectations. I stand here today to propose a grand development plan for Somalia. This new plan will focus on rebuilding social and physical infrastructures, roads, schools, hospitals, community centers, ports, airports, and markets, all of which are essential for reviving the state and the economy. The plan, aligned to the new sustainable development goals, will ensure a reduction in duplication of efforts and empower Somalis to keep building their own future. The bulk of our population is under the age of 30. They are the future of our nation. It's from them that we are borrowing today's resources, and for them that peace will pay its ultimate dividend. We must find a place for them in leadership, and we must create jobs and opportunities for them. They need the kind of opportunities and challenges that drive all young people around the world to succeed. We need to provide incentives for them to have a choice to move away from extremism. This grand plan development for Somalia, akin to a Somali Marshall Plan, will create countless opportunities for our youth to invest in their own future. Billions of taxpayers' money has been pumped into Somalia, and we have had some success, but not enough. NGOs have become a local business. Some are effective, others not. We now need a different approach. We don't want charity. We want direct investment. We need to build quality schools, fill them with quality educators, pave roads, build markets, and rejuvenate agricultural production to make us, once again, East Africa's largest exporter of quality produce. The New Deal is a useful aid framework, but we need to translate this into results, and it's about time. The development plan for Somalia will ensure accountability and transparency for every investment made. Each UN member state will have the opportunity to evolve Somalia into an economic powerhouse and a future trading partner. The plan will share with all of you in due course. Mr. President, honorable delegates, ladies and gentlemen, we are grateful to you for supporting us over the last 2.5 decades. Thank you for welcoming our people as your own, for turning a relatively small nomadic tribe from the Horn of Africa into a global workforce. And for the amount of time and resources that has been invested, we are humbled by your generosity. We'll make your efforts work for our people, but we also need your continued support. Only 4 years ago, radical insurgents controlled our country. They oppressed and threatened the lives of our people. But today, children are returning to Mogadishu and other cities along the Indian Ocean beaches. Women sit on dunes selling home-baked bananas, and the sound of bullets has been replaced by the noise of construction. Look how far we have come, and imagine what we can do in another 4 years. We're looking forward to not only bounce back for our own benefit, but to also become the shining example to nations that are now in the throes of hardship, nations that are working hard to move from the third world to the first, and nations that find it hard to navigate the difficult but worthwhile road of recovery. We are ready to play our part so that we may give back and contribute toward the success and the fulfillment of their rightful destiny, and to take our place among the contributing nations of our global village. Mr. President, honorable delegates, ladies and gentlemen, Somalia has failed my generation, and I will dedicate my life to ensuring it that does not fail the next. But I cannot do this alone. Only together can we be the Somalia the world is waiting for. Thank you very much.
On behalf of the General Assembly, I wish to thank the Prime Minister of the Federal Republic of Somalia for his statement just made, and I request protocol to escort His Excellency.